All right, we're up here at Watkins Glen International Racetrack at the heart of the Seneca Lake Wine Trail. Dave Stamp and niece Abby on the tractor, busily putting in grapevines here at the track to kind of remind people here at the track that we're living in wine country.
Yep.
So we're here next to the media center, where I think the awards are given out and whatnot.
Yep. Victory Lane.
That's a Victory Lane. And down below we got some vines that Dave already put in just a few days ago. It's here in late May. It's a normal time of year to be putting vines in?
Yeah, we're running out of cusp of being a little late. Yep.
Got it, on the back end of things.
Yep. Yes, exactly.
Because you got this winery you got to take care of too, right?
Yeah, we got our own planning to do too.
All right, so here next to you we got a big old piece of treated wood, it looks like.
Well, it's a Vinny post and a post driver, and we are going to pound it into the ground to make our trellis for the grape vines to grow on.
And then down here, you already got the vines in.
Yep, yeah, we kind of did this a little different. We didn't do any cultivation here because they really didn't want us to tear up all their lawn. So we kind of ripped it through and put the vines in, and hopefully they'll grow very well.
What kind of vines you got in the ground, Dave?
St. Croix. They're a Minnesota hybrid.
All right, why'd you choose St. Croix?
They're very winter hardy, very disease resistant, and they're a nice deep color of red. So when they get ready and ripe in the fall, they ought to be very pretty.
And something nice. Viewers might be wondering if they can hear anything over the cars. is why didn't you plant Riesling?
Well, we're up quite a ways away from the lake, so it's a little colder up here, and I wanted to have something very cold hardy, so that we didn't have any die back. And we're not going to use the grapes.
That's fine. These grapes are ornamental primarily.
Exactly.
Anyway, we're not going to make any wine out of these grapes.
Exactly. We assume people are going to pick them and eat them as they get ripe in the fall.
We hope they do.
Yes, we do.
Leave the vines be, but eat the grapes all you want.
Right, exactly. So.
All right, so now we're going to light this bad boy up. You got this hydraulic driver. How many foot-pounds are you talking about?
With 700,000.
Yeah, so that's a lot of weight. All right.
Yep.
Slam away, folks.
All right, here we go.
Joys of the work you do. You got these darn tractors to deal with.
Yeah, we just broke the damn thing.
Yeah.
Broke the right good. I don't think we can fix it here.
No.
I know we can't fix it here.
All right, I think we're gonna thank you for your time, Dave. Appreciate it. Anytime we can come up and help break your tractor, Abby, we're all about that.
Thank you.
All right.